Good morning, all of you. My name is Pankaj. I welcome all of you of this webinar, all the participants who are here, who have spared their time. We welcome all of you in this webinar session. We are providing the detail of international judgments, what the coverage we have, and what are the advantages you can take from this international judgment. Second one is the SLP linking. So in this our databases, so we have given SLP linking facilities. So I show you the feature and how you take the advantage of this feature that we will discuss. Third part is the this Word Outlook Office Connect feature, Office 365 Connect feature. I'll show you these features, how it can be helpful for you at the time of drafting or at the time of sending a mail on particular topic. So you can take the help from this our databases. Then the fourth one is the create paper book. This is again the very important thing. At the time of research, how to prepare the paper book, what are the our features, and how we take the advantages of these features to create a paper book. So I'll show you these features. Before moving on this topic, first of all, I just want to give a brief introduction of our company. As you know, Manu Patra, pioneer in online legal research in India since 2001, is India's premier legal information resource. We are known as the hardcore research tool and not a tool to take up printouts. Manu Patra is known for the hardcore research tools with so many features, and it's driven by language, natural language processing, analytics, artificial intelligence. All the AI features you will get incorporated in the Manu Patra visualization tools. It will help you to get the various analytic features, extensive hyperlinking to the judgment, act, rule, notifications. So it's not a simple judgment or not the simple judgment to take a printout. Though we have given the research tools so that you can get the visualization tools or the AI which is integrated with our databases. So people will take the advantages of these features. And the best part is the print replica we have given in this of the court website. So I'll show you the databases of the international where you will get the whatever the judgment. So they, like the US, they cite the, they refer, the honorable judge refer the court's citations. So in our databases, what we have done, just a minute, please hold on. So these things are there. I'll show you this part. And first of all, I just give you the brief about the coverage as well. The our coverage, the coverage of we cover the Supreme Court, all the judgment, all high court decisions are there. Then the travelers and commissions, we have covered 38 travelers and commission, very exhaustive databases you will get there. Then the Bayer Act and rules, notification, circular is again the very exhaustive part. Not only the central as well as the state, you will get that these legislations, notification, circulars. Whatever the bill which is pending in parliament, you will get the detail. Then the committee reports, drafted agreements, format, international database. I'll explain this part and the legal taxonomy. So I'm moving. I'm just showing you the. The international databases. I'm just logging the Manu Patra site. This is our site, manupatra.com. Most of you are aware of this, how to log in, but I am explaining you again. We have two type of login things. One is the sign-in ID based thing, or another one is the IP based. In the IP based, there is no need to even sign in. Directly, you can clicking the IP based access. It will provide you the access. And in sign-in ID, user ID and password is must to access that databases. So in this webinar, I am showing you our coverage of international databases. First of all, I can see here in the table of content what we have covered in international databases, international case law, what the coverage are there. I'm just explaining these things. I can see here the various countries' name are there. Maximum of the countries are the Commonwealth English speaking countries, but apart from the Commonwealth English speaking countries, we have covered the very extensive coverage of US databases. Then you will get the judgment of US Supreme Court from the inception and all the circuits, federal court decisions you will get in the databases as well. So these are the coverage detail you can see here, the Supreme Court of US, federal courts and statutes you will get there. The Commonwealth countries part, apart from the UK, first of all, I'll just show you the UK part, what we have covered in the UK. The Supreme Court UK decision, House of Lords, England, Wales Court of Appeal, then the English and Wales High Court, tribunals, various tribunals, that the part of that things, competition appellate tribunal, employee appellate tribunals, we have covered there. Then the Privy Council, then the High Court Justice of North Ireland, Queen's Bench, you will get these decisions in our databases. And the other Commonwealth countries like Australia, Bangladesh, Canada, Hong Kong, New Zealand, Pakistan, Singapore, South Africa, Sri Lanka, these we have covered there. Apart from that, you will get that decision of International Court of Justice, Court of Justice of European Community. Then we have covered the databases of English report as well as the maritime report. Maritime cases are there. In the English report, you will get the coverage 2020 to 1873, and the maritime cases 1870 to 1940. So these all the databases are in searchable format. The way you have searched in the Manupatra, generally the same search method are also applicable for these databases. So I'm just showing you how to search. We have given some icons to search only for international databases as well. Like suppose that if you are searching in Manu search, so we have given the court, you can select the court, Indian court or international court. Either you can select this one or you can select the international databases from this place. So like suppose that if I'm searching any, if I want to search the topic of international databases on topic like the gender justice, when you search in international databases, so it will give you the result in the similar fashion you're searching in other place. So you will get this result. Under this result, you will get the code detail with the number of cases. This filter option will allow you to see the code detail, how many judgment of which code, you will get that detail. Like suppose that I have to read the judgment of US Supreme Court. So I have to come here and I can see here. So these Supreme Court decisions you will get there of US. And that is very simple. When you click here, you will get the decision of, like suppose that if you're drafting any petition on gender justice and you want to take some portions. So you can copy paste the portion as required by you. There is no limitation. Some of the databases, they will give the limitation to take a copy paste option. So when you just select and copy I'm just opening the Word. So after pasting, you can notice here, you will get in the footnote of the name of the case. So at the time of drafting, it will help you to refer the particular case without again copying and pasting the same party name. So this feature will help you to get the drafting. At the time of drafting, it will help you. Other things in the international data, all the cases which is referred here, that is hyperlink. Like you can see here, these I'm just showing you this. First of all, I'm showing the Manu citation and the equivalent citation. You are getting the US code citation. It is mentioned here. You can search by citation wise as well. I'll show you that features. So if you have a citation of US any Supreme Court or any other international citations, you can code citation, you can search there. Then the these are the whatever the things which is red and hyperlinked, underlined, that is hyperlink. So you will get that by clicking these cases, how many cases are affirmed, how many cases discussed, how many cases are mentioned. So you will get that detail as well. So it will help you to get that most relevant thing. So you can read the most relevant judgment first by clicking this one. So and under this, you will get the case referred summary, you will get there. So whatever the case which is referred in this case law, you will get there. Vis-a-vis, at the time of reading the judgment, you can open the judgment which is referred by simple clicking of this. So it will allow you to open that judgment where it has referred. So in this way, you can open that judgment. So always it will help you at the time of drafting or you finding the relevant main advantages of using that databases. So you can notice here the various link, you will get like you are getting the link of that all the legislations as well. So it will help you to read the legislations of that particular country. So search within search facility will again allow you to narrow down that things. So you can further narrow down by clicking here. This is the one way to find the judgment through Manu search. This and here this AI integration has link. So always you will get the most relevant one on the top, but you can do ascending and descending order wise as well. So it's your choice. Most cited case you can see first of all. I'm just moving from this Manu search to legal search. So whatever the other search parameters are there, I'm just going to show you. So in this legal search, so this, you will get the party name by search, honorable judge's name by search, or date by search. You can do a search. Like suppose that if I'm trying to find out a Ranveksi judgment, so I have to write the Ranveksi name, and it is searching the databases. So I've searched the entire databases. If suppose that I have to restrict the databases of international only, then I have to select here and then I can search here. I will search in the international databases. So the judgment I got here, the Ranveksi, where the one party is the Ranveksi, you can see here the one judgment of Singapore High Court and other ones the US Federal Court decisions you are getting there. You can further narrow down by any search parameter, like I'm just searching one word like the patent. So you can refine here. So further you can refine by this on this parameter. You can find out that result in this one. Now I'm showing you the another feature, the citation search. So you will get the international citation search. So either here you have to select that citation, like suppose that I have taken the code citation of US and I'm just selecting the any of the citation of the US Supreme Court. The volume is 446 and page number is 578. And we're trying to find out the history. International databases, you have to select here, you have to select the publishers, you have to select the code name here. The Supreme Court, and then 1980. I've written the wrong year, that's why it has not taken that. 446 is the volume number, and the 578. Citation. So this is the judgment. I find we got here by the citation wise of the US Supreme Court. So this, the equivalent citation number wise, you can find out the judgment. Sometimes, so if you have any citation, like suppose that if you are receiving any, you are reading any judgment and you are getting any citation quoted, so instantly it has advantage to get that judgment from this databases. And whatever the portion, if you want to add in the draft, you can add that thing. So this feature will allow you to see that. We have noticed so many judgments. So on a various occasion, our Supreme Court mentioned that international case law. I'm just showing you one example here. I'm just taking the one example, like the NJC case. And I can see here, Supreme Court advocate on record bar association case. So what is the advantage here? You have, if you have an international databases and you are reading any Indian our judgment of Supreme Court or any court where they have referred the case law of international court. So you will get that things hyperlink here. I'm just showing you that part. So these are, like you can see here, these all the cases of that is mentioned in this databases, that is hyperlink. So instantly you can open by clicking here. So it will allow you to open that judgment of the US or any other court. If you want to see, you can open that databases. So vice versa, sometimes, so many times, our citations are cited by various other international courts. I'm just giving one or two examples. So you will get the hyperlink from that place as well. So I'm just searching the case law of one, I'm just giving one example, like how you will get that things. I can see here this one judgment of this English and was High Court Commercial Court. Here you will in this court you will get the citation of our, like I'm just trying to find out. So you can see here. So our Supreme Court decision, they have cited this ONGC case in their databases, in their judgment. So instantly you will get that judgment where these cases are referred, our cases are referred in that case law. So at the time of this will help your preparation. So or if you are preparing for any, it will help you to get the thing done properly. So things I'm just so these are the, either you can search by the date range wise or the on date wise, if you have any idea what the date wise, or if you have any idea what the honorable judge's name wise, so instantly you will get, if you're recalling some old judgment of any honorable judge of Supreme Court of US, so simply you have to write the judge's name and you can find out the judgment of that particular court. So this is the coverage of international. I'm just showing you that, like suppose that I have to just find out the our case in International Court of Justice. I'm just taking one example here, that like Jadhav case. So I'm trying to find out the Jadhav. So you get all the decision which is pronounced by the International Court of Justice. You will get that particular judgment. So the judgment you will get there. So like suppose that if I'm trying to find out, trying to read that judgment of Mr. Bijay Mallya. So I have to write the party name here. And I can search here. So it will give the result of this UK decision. So in this way, you can get the decisions, whatever the judgment which is required by you, you can find out that decisions. Certainly in the Bangladesh, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, I've seen whatever the decisions the pronounced by their apex court, they cite on the regular basis of Indian Supreme Court judgment, and it's very much, and we have given the hyperlink. So at the time of drafting the databases, drafting the petition, it will help you. Now I'm moving the another webinar, that topic. Today's topic is the SLP linking. SLP linking is the, what we have done in the SLP linking, this feature will give the advantage. So if you reading any of the high court judgment, and if you try to find out that judgment is SLP has disposed or still in that pending in the Supreme Court. So in spite of checking the Supreme Court site or various other sources, simply you have to, our feature will show you, give the advantage to like get the idea what that things the SLP disposed or still pending. So I'm just showing you that feature, how you will get that things. We have recently we have started to providing these details. So many decisions you will get that feature. I'm just showing you. I'm just taking example of the one Canara Bank. This of the Delhi High Court decision of the Canara Bank. So you can notice here that these Supreme Court sign in different color you will get in front of the party name. So this, when you keep the cursor, it will tell you this red one is for this SLP pending. So this judgment, Banarsi Das Khandelwal judgment, the SLP is still pending in the Supreme Court, and this Aswani Kumar Mehta SLP disposed by the Supreme Court. So even we have given the detail of that things. So when you click the judgment, you will get this SLP status feature. There are two signs, the SLP and this is online timeline, order timeline. So this SLP will help you to get this feature, this pending thing. So simple, you have to write that CAPTCHA is there. You have to fill this CAPTCHA and you will get this two times it will ask to fill the CAPTCHA. So then it will allow you to read the this SLP thing. So this SLP is still pending. So you will get this court this order. So here you can see here the list this case after 3 weeks or so. So this case is still pending in the Supreme Court. So various cases you will get this feature. I'm just taking some other examples as well, like So now you can see here, in this case, you are getting the, this case SLP is disposed. So these are the, it will help you at the time of reading the judgment. If you suppose that if you want to cite these case laws and you are getting the signage of SLP pending. So certainly you will try to get some other judgment to quote in that case. If SLP is disposed, then it's your decision to, you have to cite of this case law, because Supreme Court has given the final verdict on this case law. So this will help you to get the exact things, which court, which case you have to cite or not to cite. And even it will give the privilege to get the detail of that particular case, that case is SLP is still pending or not. There is no need to even visit the site. So it will save your time and it will give the proper information at the time of reading or quoting the judgment. So you will get the advantage of that thing. So this is the SLP linking thing. Now I'm moving the third part. Today's third part is Word, Outlook and Office 365 Connect. I'm just showing you. You can see here on the home page, there is a one icon on desktop. So when you click this on desktop, you will get that this features detail. This is the Chrome alert. Another one is the Word Connect, Outlook Connect. So what is this Word Connect? I'll show you directly. So that Word Connect, and then I'll explain you these things. So I'm just opening that one file here. I'm just opening one Word document. Then I'll explain you how it will work. So in the Word, you're getting here the add-in feature. So from where it has come, you have to run one small exe of this Manupatra Connect. So you have to download this one. And after downloading, it will allow you to get that feature, add-in feature of Manupatra. So simple, you have to download. Then it will, you will get this add-in feature. When you click this add-in, you will get this Manu search feature. So at the time of just reviewing your petition draft or any document, you just want to work, you want to just find some related topic on the Manupatra, or you want to refine this your draft, there is no need to open Manupatra separately. What you have to do here, just click on the add-in, what you have added by running the exe. So I have opened one draft here. When you select any word, like suppose that I'm selecting this word, I just want to explore this thing in Manupatra. So you have to select this word and search, click here the Manu search. So it will ask you, prompt you the your username password. Just feed your username password. The advantage of this add-in, so directly it will show you the results of this topic. So I got this judgment, 34 judgment, I got this on this topic. Now it's my choice. I can read here. So at the time of reading, suppose that I want to add some of the paragraph from this judgment. Like suppose that this is the case note I want to add in my draft note. So what I have to do here, simply I have to select this one. When I select here, simply I have to drag and drop. So it will allow you to get the things done instantly. So without wasting of time, you can draft, you can refine your draft, you can add some value add at the time of reading or reviewing your draft. So this will allow you. I'm just giving you more features here. Like if I want to find out, like suppose that if I'm trying to find out the judgment of, like suppose that I'm just searching any case law. Like suppose that this citation is there. One citation is there. I just try to find out this citation where it has cited. So I have to click here the citation. So you will get that judgment. You can read the full text of that judgment. Okay. So whatever the draft, if that any party name or any citation which is referred, directly you can open by simple selecting and clicking on the menu search. Here, what we have given here, so you have a facility to features here. So you can search in the free text search. First of all, I have done that one. Then you can search by the title wise. So title search is also possible. Like suppose that if you're searching any the party name, just you have to select and click the title search. Then the citation search is also there. Further, what we have given there, like suppose that if you're getting more result, you can narrowing down by the any of that quote wise as well. So these features will save you time at the time of the drafting. So instantly Word Connect feature will help you to get the relevant result. Like suppose that if I'm searching any of that I'm just trying to find out this case law. So simply I have to click here. So I got this judgment. So it's very simple. You have to select, you will get the judgment, and whatever the paragraph you want to add in your draft, simply you have to just first of all mark the place where you have to drag and drop. So first of all, that assigning that click the cursor on that place, and then select the relevant part. Like I want to take this paragraph, simply drag and drop, and it will allow you to take that course. So this feature will help you to at the time of drafting this Word Connect feature. Now I'm moving the another feature of the MS Outlook Connect. I'm just closing this window. So it will ask you to save or not. So it's a simple feature of Word. So similarly, you will get this Outlook Connect ID as well in the Manupatra homepage. So on the desktop, you will get the Outlook Connect. So here again, you have to download one EXE. So these and the compatibility of with which system and the which office also written there. So you have to download and run that EXE. Then again, the same thing as I explained the Word, I'm just showing you. I'm just taking that one draft here. So I'm just opening this draft. I have run that EXE. So I'm getting here the add-in feature. So again, the same thing, whatever the things I have done for this Outlook Word things, simply find out this Irshad Ali versus Elias Deepak. So I have to select this one and click here the menu search. Then it will prompt that username password window. If suppose that if you have received any mail from your boss or any colleague and they have given you some draft things and you are reading that draft, and this similar time you want to get the idea about that some case laws on any particular topic or any party name wise or any citation wise, simply you have to click here, select that one, click the menu search, and it will allow you to get that things. Now you can see here, this you are getting that particular judgment. You can read that particular judgment, or you can simply drag and drop what I have shown you in that time. So simply, let's suppose that I have to serve this post-cognizance stage. I have to serve this phrase. So I have to select this one and Manu search. I have to select that Manu search. So it will show you the judgment on this post-cognizance stage. What are all the judgment? So again, this again the time-saving tool. Whatever the mail you receive, or you, if you have saved in the any draft note, or if you are reviewing any of the mail, so you can review, you can add at the same time whatever the things you want to add from that desired judgment. So it will allow you to open that particular judgment. You can see that, read that particular judgment, or you can add some paragraph or text from that judgment in your draft mail. So this is the feature of Outlook Connect. For these two features, what I have explained you, it is required to run that exe. It is first of all, when you run this exe, then you will get the add-in feature, and then both the places it will run. So exe feature, yeah, these both the Connect and Outlook Connect and Word Connect, you will get the separate exe. So you have to run that separately, both the exe, then you can see on that thing. So this is the Word and Outlook Connect. And now I'm coming that so many of you use this Office 365. Online Office, you use the 365. I'm just going to show you the what are the advantages you will get from Manu Patra at the time of if you are accessing if you are using that Office 365. So it will prompt after I'm just signing this Office 365. I'm just showing you that feature. These all the three tools are helpful at the time of drafting, at the time of preparing the final note with the help of our Manu Patra, these adding tools. Now I have opened the one draft note. Before this showing the draft note, I'll just try to explain you. So when you open this Office 365, and the Word, you will get this insert option. So in this insert option, you will get here the add-in feature. So add-in feature on this Microsoft site, on this store, on the Microsoft store, you will get the various add-in. So these add-in you can add in the Word. So here in the Microsoft site, you will get the Manu Patra things. So when you search this Manu Patra, so Microsoft provides the add-in of the Manu Patra legal research add-in. So there's the single online tool which you will get on this legal tool, you will get on that Microsoft Office add-ins things. So what you have to do here, you have to simply add the things, and I have already added. So I'm getting here in adding, after adding up this thing, you will get that whatever the things you have done in my adding, you will get the list of that, all the add-ins. So you have to just select that Manu Patra adding and add. So whatever the things I have done previously for Word and Outlook, same thing you will get that in the same in here as well. Slight bit difference is there. I'm just showing you the difference. Like suppose that if I'm searching here any of that I'm just taking any one example. So I've selected, I'm just logging through my username password. So I've selected here, and I got this judgment, so it is showing the first four lines. If you want to read the full judgment, you have to open here. So when you open, then it will allow you to read the full text judgment. Now, I am reviewing my draft. I want to add some of the portion from this judgment. So even here, like I have to add this portion in this place. So even there is no need to even drag and drop as well. So simply what you have to do, you have to just select that particular portion and you will get here, click here to insert selected text. So simply you have to click here, you will get the things in your draft. So it's very simple. There is no need to copy, paste or anything. So in adding features of Manupatra will allow you to add the required or desired text of any of the judgment, you can add directly from that place. So I'm just going to explain you. Here you will get the features like the quote wise you can search, you can narrow down that one. And we have given the separate these things, free text search, title search and citation search. The similar thing what I explained you earlier, the same thing you will get there. Even here you will get the query definition, what is the meaning of that any particular word. I'm just giving the one example here. I'm just taking any of the word from this, like suppose that guarantee. I'm just taking this word. So I have selected that word, I'm getting the result. I have not written here, I have not clicked the Manupatra, any of the icon directly. When you select, you will get the things. And query definition will allow you the simple meaning of this guarantee, you are getting that meaning as well. So it will save you a lot of time. At the time of drafting, it will save you a lot of time. Whatever the things instantly you want to do any research work, you want to get the query of that things, or if you want to get the related result of that things, so it will help you. I just want to search in one in Supreme Court. So what I have to do, I have selected the Supreme Court and search. So now it is searching the guarantee in the Supreme Court. I got that result. So I have opened this judgment. I want to add the here the paragraph of this thing. So simply I have to select here and click here. It will add that particular paragraph. So this is the feature of Word Outlook Connect. Word Connect and that so now I'm just going to show you another feature. Just a minute. I'm just going to show you. Now I'm moving to another part that this sticky note of this paper book option. I'll show you how to create the paper book. Please hold on just a minute. I'm just it is. So in this paper book, I'll just going to show you the how to create the paper book. So these all the features detail I have given in this training manual as well. So whatever the things in the explain you, or so these all the detail you will get there. Here you will get the things. I'll show you how to create the paper book. So whatever the feature if you want to see, so all the detail you will get there. We have given the this in this training manual, the how to use the videos. So whatever the features I've explained you, Word Connect. So simply you have to run this video and you will get that detail of that feature. So so this is the way to just get the idea what the things. I'm showing you that. I'm just showing you how the paper book you can create. I'm just taking one example here, like the appointment. Arbitrator. I'm searching this one. So you can see here, just a minute. So I'm just selecting some of the judgment here. So I just want to add, there is one sticky note option. I'm just showing you that sticky note option. I can see here. This sticky note option will allow you, see this highlight option and this comment option will allow you to add your comment, this highlight that relevant, like suppose that I want to mark this portion. And add my comment. So you can add your comment here. And you can add your comment with the whatever the things subtopic you have created, or you can create your own topic by clicking on this one. So you have to click there the topic and you have to give the some title here. Like I'm just giving, you can write your the note here. So then you can save here. So in this way you can add your this sticky note with the relevant paragraph. I'm just opening the other judgment. Like I'm reading this judgment and some of the paragraph is important. I want to quote in this, take this prepare the thing, this paragraph. So I have to click the sticky note and then I have to just mark that paragraph. Like suppose that I have to mark this paragraph. So I take the highlighter. So any of the color you can take and highlight that paragraph. And then you can add your comment. So I'm just adding my comment here. By clicking right cursor, you can add your topic. Like I have added the topic, because any of the topic you can create or add. Or you can write your comment. So after this, creating these relevant paragraph marking with this sticky note option, what you will get there, whatever the relevant paragraph you have marked and you have given this this comment option with that particular topic wise, so it all be compiled in the sticky note place. In the home page, you will get the sticky note option. And here you will get that all the cases where you have compiled, you will get the sticky note summary. So in this place, you will get your sticky note summary. So like suppose that I have to see in this arbitration topic, how many important paragraphs or things I have marked there. So I have to just click here. So I'll get all the portions. So two portions recently I have added and some of the portions previously I have added in this place, you will get all the portions. And then you have to create a one paper book. Simply you have to take a printout or you have to download. So this printout will allow you take a printout of your whatever the paragraph you have marked in that place, and you have whatever the comment you have given there. So with this comment and topic wise, you will get the details. So it will save you the time instead of taking the full text judgment things and whatever the relevant part you are marking underlying in this by your highlighter. So there is no need to do that one. Simply you have to take a mark that relevant part and add your comment with that feature. So you can compile these things by simple selecting and adding your comments. So it will save the paper and it will save that your time. So get the things. You can search in the comments as well, whatever the things, like suppose that I have to search anything in the arbitration, I want to search sole arbitrator I have created. So it will search and it will give that sole arbitrator's topic here. So it will allow you to take that printout of these things as well. Okay. So this is the one way to create the paper book, whatever the things which is required on that particular judgments paragraph. Like suppose that some paragraphs are important, I have to just mark, add that sticky note, and that is compiled. And you can take printout so that you can create a paper book. Another one I'm just going to show you. Sometimes you want to take a various judgment. Like I'm just doing searching one topic. I've searched here the gender justice. Like suppose that this judgment I read this judgment and this judgment is important. So simply we have to add in the add to session list. So this judgment will added in the my session list. Okay. So you will get things here, the session list. So whatever the required desired judgment, you have to take a printout. So you simply have to take this add to session list. So whatever the important judgment you have marked there. So all the judgment you will get I have marked the two judgment in session list. Like suppose that I want to add another one judgment like this one. I read this judgment and this is again important. So I have added in the my session list. In the last of the session, if you want to create the paper book of these all the three judgments, simply you have to click the session list and this print option will allow you to get the relevant. Like suppose that I have to create the paper book of these all the three judgments, you have to click the print option in one document, all the three judgments you will get there. Either you can save in the PDF, or you can see here, all the three judgments you will get in this thing. So either you can save or you can take a printout. So these are the way to create the paper book. So when you save, so you can get the things on your desktop, or directly you can take a printout through this one. So this is the way to prepare your paper book through my session list or a sticky note. So in the sticky note, you are getting the advantage to add the relevant part for your important part and create a paper book. And here, if you want to take the entire judgment and create the paper book, simply you have to select to add to session list and it will create that things. So this is the paper book things. So these three parts I've shown you that all the four parts I've covered there. Now, you can ask your questions. If you have any questions, please ask me. Please raise your hand. Yes, please ask me.
So can you hear me?
Yeah, please tell me, ma'am.
So when I tried to do this Supreme Court search that you showed me simultaneously, no results found. When I put the same details as you put, as Murthy Devi and Delhi in the advanced search option.
No, that is the Murthy Devi. Delhi is the High Court decision. Delhi High Court decision, not the Supreme Court decision.
Yeah.
So you are getting the just the party name, right? The Murthy Devi Delhi, because party name, the full party name is Murthy Devi versus State of Delhi, right?
Correct. So I do legal search then I do advanced search.
No, there is no need to just click the advanced search and this party name, simply write Murthy Devi Delhi, right?
Oh, yes. My page is just loading.
And when you search, just select the that where you will get that SLP features icon. So yeah, it will show you that particular judgment. If it is a green, the dispose of, or if it is a red, that is the pending thing.
So I am in advanced search right now. I'm not selecting anything. In appellant stroke respondent, I have written.
Write the Murthy Devi. M-U-R.
Yeah.
Murthy Devi Delhi. Right?
Yes, sir. And then I write search.
Yes.
Now.
You must have received.
Yeah. Now it shows the case laws, but I don't get this symbol that. Okay.
What the things? The green color icon, you are getting the either the sixth or seventh one.
Yes, minus the fourth one, sir.
Yes. There's so many judgments. It's not that I have given the some example in that place. There's so many judgments you get there, these features. You will so many judgments which are, they have filed the SLP in the Supreme Court. So you will get the status of all the cases. It is not necessary. Okay, thank you.
Okay, so and my second question was, I had mentioned that I am not able to see, I have full access website to Manupatra. I am not able to see this courts tab that you just showed us in the first 5 minutes.
Then the top on the right hand side, you will get this court tab. Either your things, I'll take your query. Okay, ma'am. You can write a mail. Okay.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Vikrant, please tell me.
Yes, can you hear me?
Yeah, please.
Okay, so I just wanted to confirm that you showed us the Word, Outlook, and the Microsoft Office 365 feature.
Right.
So is it also available for the people who have login access through IP? Because when you were trying to log in, I only saw the username and password option.
So IP access, there is no need to sign in on that thing. And that place directly, it you can open that thing.
Okay, in the Word and Outlook?
With IP access, you will get that open. Access, so there is no need to sign in. It will open directly.
Okay, all right. Thank you.
Okay. Please ask me. Yes, please ask me.
Sir, I just wanted to know whatever the webinars are there, the previous webinars, are they available on the training manual which you have shown? Because I just missed two of the webinars in the previous 2 days.
We will send you the link that please mail us at contact@manupatra.com.
I have actually mailed it 2 days before. So if we can just revert that, it would be well appreciated.
Okay. We will send you that thing.
Okay, sir. Fine. Thank you very much.
Any other question?
No, not as such. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.